Jesus, the Holy Spirit, who is with us right now, to your pastor, Pastor Hudson, to Bianca. I think you were talking earlier. I have not officially met her yet, but to Bianca, who has given me the opportunity to speak. There is four people that are here today. Latia Masterson, my sister-in-law, her children, Aiden and Emily, and a man that has traveled from Chesapeake, Virginia. I call him Papa. He's more like a spiritual grandfather to me, Herman Jenkins. He is here as well. I am married. I have three children. Their names are Pamela, Ayana, and Soren. Today's scripture is already read, but I'm going to look up one verse, and then we're going to deal with 25 to 34. Matthew chapter 6, verse 25. We're going to read part A. Therefore, I say to you, don't worry about your life.
Amen.
I want to preach and teach from the subject this morning. God's biblical answers to the problem of worry. God's biblical answers to the problem of worry. Perfect. Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you that we have another opportunity, God, to stand behind your sacred desk to bring forth your word. God, I pray, God, that you take me out of this place. God, hide me behind the darkest part of your cross. Holy Spirit, empower me. Anoint my head, anoint my feet, anoint my hands, my mouth, my ears, God, and my eyes. So that your people, God, will not see me, so they will see all of you. May in this time, God, that we open up your word, may you bless our time. May you receive the glory, honor, and praise. In your holy and righteous Son's name, Jesus the Christ. Amen.
Amen.
God's biblical answer for the problem of worry. Bobby McFerrin wrote a song called Don't Worry, Be Happy. Are y'all familiar with that song?
Yes.
Okay, so that means I don't have to tell you about this song. You know, Bobby goes and says, don't worry, be happy. Somebody took your bed. Don't worry, be happy. You might not have a place to lay your head. Don't worry, be happy. To the young people, do y'all know who Pharrell Williams is? Y'all do? Y'all should know that he wrote a song called Happy. It might seem crazy to think what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here. You can break. Clap your hands. I'm happy, I'm happy, I'm happy. Even though Bobby and Pharrell gives us this, they talk about life's problems and circumstances. But their solution is to be happy. Well, let me tell you something. You can't just go through life just being happy. Life has a way of tossing and turning you. Life has a way of pressing you down. And from their standpoint, they're saying be happy. Happiness won't pay the bills. Happiness won't pay those student loans off. Are you worried this morning? Are you worried, college student, that you made the right decision, the right major, the right focus? Are you worried that those that have just graduated, of what college or university you should attend? Are you worried that your parents have saved enough money to help you go through school? Are you worried about paying tuition, books, room, and board?
Yeah.
Parents, are you worried? Are you worried that when you send your son or daughter, grandchild, niece or nephew off to college, are you worried that they will make the right decision while they are there? Are you worried that you have given your child, your children, enough skills and lessons of life so that they can make the right decisions? What are you worried about this morning? Reverend Lee says this about worry. Worry is feeling uneasy or being over-concerned about a problem or a situation. With excessive worry, our mind and body goes into overdrive. It constantly thinking what might happen. Worry, my friends, will make you physically ill. It will cause dizziness, dry mouth, fatigue, and headache. Psychology Today says this about worry. Worry will sneak up on you like a thief in the night and take your joy. Take whatever it wants to. Are you worried about, what are you worried about this morning? In our passage of scripture, Jesus mentions worry. In verse 25, he says, don't worry. In verse 27, he said, which of you by worry can add a cubit to your stature? Verse 28, he says, why do you worry? Verse 31, he says, don't worry. And verse 34, he says, don't worry. Five times Jesus mentions worry. I would like this morning to give you some negative reasons of why we worry. But then I want to give you some positive answers to counter those negative reasons. Five times worry is mentioned. The Greek word for worry means to divide or draw in different directions. That's what anxiety does. The old English meaning of worry or anxiety means to strangle. The Latin meaning means to choke or to torment. So when we worry, it makes our mind unsound. It's like we're taking our own life because we're so worried about what the next issue is going to be in life. We worry because we have a lack of understanding of who the true and living God is. Our answer to counter this reason is that God, who is the creator of life, my friends, is able to sustain it as well. Verse 25, don't worry. God, Elohim, my creator, your creator, God the Father being the supervisor. When they spoke in Genesis chapter 1, Jesus being the architect and the Holy Spirit being the contractor, created life, and they are able to sustain it as well.
All right.
Verse 26, Jesus says, look. Look here is a command, meaning to focus, to stare upon, to contemplate, to look distinctly. Jesus is emphatically saying for us to take a good look at the birds. Did y'all see the birds this morning flying around? Did y'all see the birds outside picking some worms up? Jesus says, look at the birds. It is interesting that God will take a helpless sparrow and use him to be a theologian and preacher to help us understand God. If God provides for a worm, he shall provide for you. Another reason why we worry is we worry because we have a lack of understanding of who we are to him, our worth to God. You are answer to this lack of understanding is that you, me, are more worthy than a bird or a flower. One of our problems is that we do worry in life. We do at times. We might not worry if we're going to drink or eat, but we might at times worry if we paid the right bill on time. We might worry if we got enough money in the bank to get us to the gas station to more worthy than a flower. Consider is another command. He says, consider the lilies of the field. He's saying for us to study some flowers. Do they toil or spin? But they are God's glory. God clothes the grass, and they are alive today and gone tomorrow. Do you think flowers worry? Do you think a flower worries that it's going to receive enough sunshine today and rain tomorrow? I don't think flowers worry. I don't think grass worries either. I've learned owning a house that grass will grow a lot faster if you don't cut it constantly.
Remember that I stand in God.
version said this, that our anxiety empties tomorrow of its sorrows. It also empties today of its strength. In conclusion, we must trust God. Proverbs 3:5-6 says, trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not into thy own understanding, but all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct thy path. Remember, Jesus is the God that is the creator of life. They're able to sustain it, and well, you are more worthy than a bird and a flower. You are more worthy than the animals that pick up worms every morning. I'll give my help from you. You can trust in the Lord because he knows all your circumstances. Keep your trust in him. Here with us. Yes. God, help us to remember these answers to the power of the word. God, we must put all our trust in you. We must seek you first, the kingdom of God, and all your righteousness, and everything will be added unto us. God, I pray for these graduates. God, I pray for these parents. I pray for these grandparents, aunts and uncles, family members, and all family members of the friends. That God, when we start to work, may you be that still small voice.
Yes, yes, yes.
That calls us to call attention to you. That you may handle, and you can handle. Not only have you handled our past situations, not only will you handle our present situations, but because you are the same yesterday, today, and forevermore, you can and will handle the future. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' precious name.